Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Open Mic Night live at the ZoomBarDC. We've got a great show for you all tonight. We've got Megan Ukoh, Dave Sherman, Scott Kaplowitz, Warren Hayford, Vadim Levy, Bill Sherman, Ed Crowley, Ryan Layton, and Ryan's going to kick us off.
What's going on, everybody?
Hey.
I want to roll. I learned another new one, so we're going to give it a shot, and we'll see what happens. You guys can hear everything, yeah? Cool. Well, you must understand the touch of your hand makes my pulse react. That it's only the thrill of a boy meeting girl. Opposites attract, it's physical, logical. Try to ignore that it means more than that. Whoa, what's love got to do with it? What's love but a second emotion? What's love got to do with it? Who needs a heart when a heart can be broken? May seem to you that I'm acting confused when you're close to me. If I tend to look dazed, I've read it someplace. I've got cause to be, there's a name for it. A phrase that fits. But whatever the reason, you do it for me. Whoa, what's love got to do with it? What's love but a second emotion? What's love got to do with it? Who needs a heart when a heart can be broken? Ooh, yeah. I've been taking on a new direction, but I have to say, I've been thinking about my own protection. It pains me to feel this way. What's love got to do with it? What's love but a second emotion? What's love got to do with it? Who needs a heart when a heart can be broken? What's love got to do with it? What's love but a sweet old-fashioned notion? What's love got to do with it? Who needs a heart when a heart can be broken?
Yeah. Yeah.
Tina Turner, right?
Yeah.
And she was just inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame for the second time.
Oh, nice. That's sick.
Well, I like your interpretation.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, definitely.
Thank you. Yeah, I heard it somewhere and I was like, all right. It's one of those earworm things, you know, you just got to learn it.
Yeah.
When that song was on the charts, my 9-year-old son started singing it. And I was like, because I have in mind the way she was singing it.
Yeah.
That's not an appropriate song for a 9-year-old.
That's fair.
So I said, no, you know, there's plenty of nice music on Sesame Street. He said, well, what's wrong with it? So I ran the lyrics over in my mind. And, yeah, there really isn't. The lyrics are fine. Don't sing them the way Tina Turner sang them. That's.
Well, Well, it's just, you know, it's kind of like Rocky and Bullwinkle. It's on a couple of different levels.
Yeah.
It's in the mind of the beholder.
There you go. All right, I got one more, and then I'll get out the way. This is a more modern pop princess. I think I did it again. I made you believe we're more than just friends. Oh, baby, it might seem like a crush, but it doesn't mean that I'm serious. 'Cause to lose all my senses, well, it's just so typically me. Oh, baby, baby, oops, I did it again. I played with your heart, got lost in the game. Oh, baby, baby, oops, you think I'm in love, that I'm sent from above. I'm not that innocent. You see, the problem is this, I'm dreaming away, wishing that heroes did truly exist. I cry watching the days. Can't you see I'm a fool in so many ways? 'Cause to lose all my senses, well, it's just so typically me. Oh, baby, baby, oops, I did it again. I played with your heart, got lost in the game. Oh, baby, baby, oops, you think I'm in love, then I'm sent from above. I'm not that innocent, say, oops, I did it again. I played with your heart, got lost in this game. Oh, baby, oops, you think that I'm sent from above, sent from above. I'm not that innocent.
Wonderful. Well, you made him your own.
Nice beard.
I really enjoyed your voice, Ron.
I was hit all right.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Have you ever heard, who's that cat, Donovan Franken? Dude, you... I just got turned on to him, but listen to his stuff. And of course you won't agree with this, but your voice is like right in that wheelhouse. What's his name? Donovan
Frankenreiter?
Yep. That's the cat. Have you heard him?
I haven't. I just did. Dude, Donovan Frank, he popped up.
Dude, you got to listen to his stuff, cuz when I hear it, I hear your voice. And I'll he does some out. Really hip stuff. He does some really, it's right in your wheelhouse.
Oh yeah, check it out. That's awesome.
Yeah, it's right in your wheelhouse. Yeah.
Thanks, Ryan.
Thank you.
Okay, Scott, do you want to go next?
Sure. I am not using piano today, even though I do have it, just because I wanted to do some a cappella things where I sing with many copies of myself. The me's in the background are me through GarageBand on my phone. The first one I've done before, it's a song called Night We Met. It's by a band called Lord Huron, which, interesting band name. Let's see if this is loud enough. Let me know if y'all hear like 8 billion Scots right now. Hold on, let's see this again. Y'all hear some voices?
Yep.
I am not the only traveler who has not repaid his debts. I've been searching for a trail to follow again. Take me back to the night we met. And then I can't tell myself what the hell I'm supposed to do. And then I can't tell myself not to ride along with you. I had all of them, most of you, some now, none of you. Take me back to the night we met. I don't know what I'm supposed to do, honey, but I'm ghost to you. Take me back to the night we met. When the night was full of terrors, and your eyes were filled with tears. When you had not touched me yet, take me back to the night we met. I had all of them, most of you, some of them, none of you. Take me back to the night we met. I don't know what I'm supposed to do, haunted by the ghost in you. Take me back to the night we met.
Wow, that was cool. That was very cool.
Balance sound okay on that?
Oh yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah, that was very cool.
Thank you. The other one, we're going to see how it works because you guys. Okay. The other one, I only have me recorded for the chorus because that's how the original song goes. I just learned about this song. I have a feeling there's probably at least one person here who has heard of the song Northwest Passage by Stan Rogers. Is this ringing a bell for anyone? No? All right, cool. Y'all are going to learn a new song today. This is one of those songs that sounds like it's been around for like 200 years. And then I looked it up and it was written in like 1981, which makes sense, I guess. But the music is very kind of sea shanty feeling. This is me with a bunch of me's in the background again. The reason I say we're going to see how it works is because I only have the chorus recorded because the verses is just me. So we'll see if I manage to stay on key. We'll see if I manage to stay on time. We'll find out. Let's see, where's my note? All right. I'm going to wait till this siren in the background of me has passed. I don't know if y'all can hear it, but I can. There's like 12 of them. I live near Great Falls Park, so when there's this many sirens, it generally means someone fell into the river, which is usually not a good thing, so hopefully they're okay. All right, I think they have mostly passed. Okay. For just one time, I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching toward the Beaufort Sea, tracing one warm line through our land so wild and savage, to make a Northwest Passage to the sea. 'Twas westward from the Davis Strait, 'twas there it was said to lie, the sea route to the Orient, for which so many died. Seeking gold and glory, leaving weathered broken bones and a long forgotten lonely cairn of stones. For just one time I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching toward the Beaufort Sea, tracing one warm line through a land so wild and savage. Take a Northwest Passage to the sea. 3 centuries thereafter, I take passage over land in the footsteps of brave Kelso, where his sea of flowers began, watching cities rise before me and behind me sink again. This tardiest explorer driving hard across the plain. For just one time I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching toward the Beaufort Sea, tracing one warm line through a land so wild and savage, to make a Northwest Passage to the sea. And through the night behind the wheel, the mileage clicking whets, I think upon Mackenzie, David Thompson, and the rest, who cracked the mountain rampart and did show a path for me to raise the roaring treasure to the sea. For just one time I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching toward the Beaufort Sea, tracing one warm line through a land so wild and savage, to make a Northwest Passage to the sea. How then am I so different from the first men through this way? I had myself a settled life, I threw it all away to seek a Northwest Passage at the call of many men, to find there but the road back home again. For just one time I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching toward the Beaufort Sea, tracing one warm line through a land so wild and savage, to make a Northwest Passage to the sea.
That was excellent.
That was fantastic. Scott Kaplowitz.
Nice. That was excellent.
Can I ask a technical question? Do you basically,
yes,
to do all the multi-tracking, do you sing one song and do it over and over and over again repeatedly, or do you use technology to multiply your voices? In other words,
no, I sang each of those tracks just into GarageBand on the iPhone.
So you sang, but you sang the passages in serial form, one after another, and
yeah,
then
so there's like. There's one passage of me doing the low part, which is just one time, take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching toward the Beaufort Sea. And then there's another one of the middle one, which I think is just one time, I would take the Northwest Passage. And then the really high one is just one time, I would
take the Northwest Passage to find the Hunt of Franklin, and so on. That one I had to do more takes on.
That's wild. So basically you're doing what George Martin and the Beatles did in the 60s in a big studio over weeks on your garage band at home. So that's pretty impressive.
Yes, it takes much less than weeks, thankfully. And then I throw a few effects on it. Like I get some reverb on the bass parts. I'll turn the bass up and the treble down on the higher parts. I'll actually turn the treble down also, because otherwise they are really loud.
Okay. That was awesome.
Warren, do you know this song? You were like the one person who I was like, maybe Warren knows this song.
I don't know the song. I loved it. I don't know it though.
So
it's a traditional sea shanty though.
Yeah, it was written in 1980. It sounds like it was written like way older, long ago. If y'all want to look up this song, the original is by Stan Rogers and the arrangement is just like that, but it's in the key of D instead of the key of E, but it's a bunch of people on the chorus, then just him on the verses. And if you want to listen to another interesting version, the first version I heard, which is how I came across this song, was a power metal version by a Canadian band called Unleash the Archers.
What's the name of the song exactly?
Northwest Passage.
Yeah.
It sounds like the theme from a 1940s movie.
Yeah, it sounds like it's perfect art. 1950s. Sounds like it's been around forever. It's one of those timeless songs. All right, thanks, y'all.
Thanks, Scott. Ned, do you want to go next?
You caught me off guard. Sure. Of course I will.
Okay, thanks.
Of course I will. All right, well, this is going to be a single track of my voice because I would have no idea how to do that. But I do have to ask this question. Scott, by any chance, are you 31 years old?
I am not. I am younger. I am 26.
26, okay. Because my son, who's 31, like records like incredible stuff on the GarageBand on his phone. It's just fascinating to me.
I'm getting there, but I'm hoping to record some stuff on my computer with some more sophisticated software. All right, let you see.
All right, I'm going to do a Sonny Boy Williamson 2 song to start things off. Now, keep our business to yourself. You gotta do me a favor now. Keep our business to yourself. Don't want you talk to nobody. Don't tell nobody else. You got a husband, I got a wife. If you keep on talking, gonna mess up my life. Do me a favor, darling, keep our business to yourself. Don't want you to talk to nobody. Don't tell nobody. Your mother, don't tell your father, don't whisper to your brother, don't mention it to your sister. You gotta do me a favor, darling, keep our business to yourself. Don't want you to talk to nobody, don't tell nobody else. When I see your picture, wanna be your man. Be your lover, wanna hold your hand, cause you gotta do me a favor, darling. Keep our business to yourself. Don't want you to talk to nobody. Don't tell nobody else. You gotta do me a favor now. Keep our business to yourself. You gotta do me a favor, darling. Keep our business to yourself. Don't want you to talk to nobody. Don't tell nobody.
Yeah.
Dave, that was for you.
Thank you. Yeah.
That was for you, brother.
Thank you, man.
I like the rundown thing that you did. That's very good.
Thank you.
You're right.
I like the music chord. Yeah.
That was great.
Performance. Two.
What's that?
One, great performance. Two, I appreciate the inherent irony in writing and recording a song about how you aren't supposed to tell anyone anything, but also selling the song to go
while you're telling the story. Yeah. Right. That's like the dog that was named Stay. You say, come here, stay, come here, stay. Yeah.
Oh, man.
It's very confusing.
I posted.
I don't get it.
For fans of Sonny Boy Williamson, there's a famous dialogue with Leonard Chess I posted on YouTube where he argues with the producer and you can hear the audio track.
Oh, that's classic, yeah.
It's called Little Village.
Yeah, that's good stuff. All right, and in effort to learn another song, I'm going to stumble through this one. This is a Bruce Springsteen song. I can't even say it. When I get home from my job, I turn on my TV, but I can't keep my mind on the show. When I lay down at night, I can't get no sleep, so I turn on my radio. But the only sound I hear is you whispering in my ear the words that you used to say. Now my days grow longer and my love grows stronger, and the fever gets worse every day. I got the fever for this girl. Oh, he got the fever. Nothing that a poor boy can do when he's got the fever for this girl. I got the fever, let this little boy blue. I can remember coming home, see her standing at the store with dishes on the table, dinner ready to go. Well, maybe we'll go out to a movie show, something that you'd like to see. Well, you're the sun in the morning and my moon at night. When I think about you, I feel all right. While the days grow longer and my love grows stronger, and the fever gets so bad every night, I got the fever for the girl. I got the fever. Nothing that this boy can do when he's got the fever for this girl. He got the fever. Let this little boy blue. Thank you. I can remember coming home, turning on my TV, but I can't keep my mind on the show. Well, when I lay down at night, oh, I can't get no sleep. So I turned on the radio, but the only thing I hear is you whispering in my ear the words that you used to say. Now the days grow longer and my love grows stronger, and the fever gets bad every day. I got the fever for this girl. I've got the fever, nothing that a poor boy can do when he's got the fever for this girl. Oh, I got the fever, left this little boy blue, got the fever for a girl. Oh, I got the fever, nothing that I can do, nothing that. Well, there's nothing that I can do.
Excellent take on that, man.
That was really fantastic.
Nice. Very nice.
Man, perfect. Bruce, I think Bruce would appreciate it, particularly in his more recent rootsy period. By the way, I have the view that any song that has the word fever in it is going to be good. So I posted Little Willie John's original Fever. That is a great interpretation. Then got famous later as a pop song.
Do you know who wrote that, Art?
No, I do not.
A guy named Otis Blackwell from Linthicum, Maryland.
Oh, yes. And Otis was a regular writer for Elvis, too, right?
Right. That's right.
I actually can send you, a friend of mine did interviews with Otis. He's a broadcaster and editor of a music magazine in Oregon. He has interviews with Otis Blackwell.
Yeah, I've seen him. And it's like you're going, Elvis just was channeling Otis Blackwell on his RCA stuff.
Right. I mean,
he was just channeling Otis Blackwell, man.
You know what, we'll move on quickly, but Elvis really had great taste in song selection, because I know the Colonel didn't have any brain for song selection. It was the Elvis himself.
No, he knew how to make stars. That's all he knew.
And get 50%.
Yeah, 50%, right.
Yeah, get his name attached. Yeah.
Okay, thanks. Thanks, Ed. Megan, you want to go next?
Yep. Thank you. Alrighty. So just like Ed, I'm trying to learn new songs as well. Okay. So yeah, I want to do this one song. Her name is by Barbara Lynn. She's actually from like the same town that I'm from in Texas. So I was like, oh wow. I've always wanted to learn the song. I think for me, it's just like, I didn't really feel like I had like a lot of examples of like other female guitarists. I was like, oh, that's so cool that I'd known about her like earlier when I'm starting, but I learned about her later in life. And yeah, I just wanted to learn her songs and just, yeah. So it's just one of her biggest hits that I'll do. If you should lose me, oh yeah, you'll lose a good thing. If you should lose me, oh yeah, you lose a good thing. You know I love you, do anything for you, just don't mistreat me. I'll be good to you. Because if you should lose me, oh yeah, you'll lose a good thing. I'm giving you one more chance for you to do right. If you only straighten out, we'll have a good life. Cause if you should lose me, oh yeah, you'll lose a good thing. This is my last time, not asking anymore. If you don't do right, I'm on my shut the door. And if you don't believe me, oh yeah, you lose a good thing. Just try that, and you lose a good thing. Just try that, and you lose a good thing. Just try that, and you lose a good thing.
That's a great tune. Absolutely.
I hated that one.
One of my faves. Yeah.
Like I never knew of her, like, yeah, until a couple of years ago.
I
posted some info. I had no idea she even existed. I heard the song, but I didn't know what a unique figure she was. A kind of bluesy R&B female instrumentalist, left-handed. I mean, they're in the 60s. Come on, early. Who is doing that? Like, nobody.
Exactly.
Who did that originally?
Barbara
Lynn.
Oh yeah, Barbara Lynn. Yeah.
From the same place. Ah. My sex is crazy. Yeah.
Wow. Very, very cool song selection.
Yeah. Yeah, I want to do another song by another favorite female singer of mine. Same kind of genre style of song that she does. I'm a really huge big fan of Amy Winehouse, so I'm gonna do one of her songs. It's a gravity tune. Well, sometimes I go out by myself and I look across the water and I think of all the things, what you're doing, and in my head I paint a picture. Since I've come home and my body's been a mess, and I miss your ginger hair and the way you like to dress. Why don't you come on over? Stop making a fool out of me. Why don't you come on over, Valerie? Valerie. Valerie. Valerie, did you have to go to jail? Put your house on up for sale. Did you get a good boy? I hope you didn't catch a 10. I hope you find the right man who'll fix it for you. Are you shopping anywhere? Change the color of your hair. Are you busy? Did you have to pay that fine that you were dodging all the time? Are you still dizzy? Since I've come home and my body's been a mess, and I miss your ginger hair and the way you like to dress. Why don't you come on over? Stop making a fool out of me. Why don't you come on over, Valerie? Valerie. Valerie. Why don't you come on over and
out of sight. Beautiful. It's wonderful. Wonderful.
Thank you.
I'm going to urge this. You guys,
great job, Megan.
Please, post where you're going to be performing in person anytime soon. B, all you musicians may know of different venues that the others don't know about that could, you know, feature your kind of musics. And if you could share info with each other, it'd be great, because I'd love to see all of you people live in whatever venues you work with, you know? So looking forward to it. You know, things are opening up. So
thanks, Art.
It was okay. Just great.
Thanks, Megan. Thanks, Megan. That was awesome. Vadim, do you want to go next?
Yeah, I could.
Okay.
Well, this is what I'm thinking. There's a kind of a well-known group band back in 1972. They had an album called Magician's Birthday. It's called Uriah Heep. I love them dearly. And they had very melodical stuff. So here's one of my favorite ones here. It's actually called Rain. It's raining outside, that's not unusual. Way that I'm feeling becoming usual. I guess you could say the clouds are moving away, away from your day and into it's raining inside. Ain't that a shame? It's getting to me, happy man. Why would you want to waste all my time? The world is yours, but I. Measuring carefully my years. Shame, shame, shame in my mind. See what you've done to my life. Rain, rain, rain in my tears. Measuring carefully my ears. Shame, shame, shame in my mind. See what you've done to my life. See what you've done to my life. Song.
Beautiful song.
Yeah, 1972, and I guess it's still good. In my personal.
Who was that by?
Uriah Heep.
Okay.
And the album was called Magician's Birthday. Last time we actually do this on the other open mic, Dave Garoz just picked up on it. Yeah, Magician's Birthday. Some people know it. Some don't.
That's great.
I didn't even know Uriah Heep did those kind of songs for their album covers and everything. I just thought they were kind of a generic. Art rock band, you know, but that was really good song.
Yeah, there was they were good. So I want to do some instrumental. This is the other one that guys probably heard. I mean, we're talking about Gant and Ed and others. I like this. I like this one. It's called Sunny. Originally this song was very slow, like Sunny. I kind of like the funky version of that. So here we go.
With the half diminished chords.
No, I don't. I mean, I'm just going to play all majors and see what happens. So
that's not going to work.
No? All right, hang on. Let me see. I'm just going to try to turn the microphone off so it doesn't sit in the way.
Much out of sight. Yeah.
Excellent. I thought I'd mix a few things just to make it interesting.
Dave's and my sister would have really, really loved that because her name.
That's
was
a great tune.
That was
yeah,
really...
which one?
I'm really disappointed you only used three keyboards, though.
Yeah, really. Yeah.
yeah.
I love that. That was so great. Thank you so much, Vadim. I love that.
Well, we're taking requests, right, Ed? We're taking requests. Next time it's going to be ukulele and me. We'll just see.
There you go. There you go.
Especially with your chords, like at the end, I said, shit, he's doing this in ukulele. That's good.
Wow.
I don't even know how you did it.
That's really cool. You can double up on piano and organ. Is this a synthesizer? How are you getting it? Is that a synthesizer? These are electronic organ, electronic piano, not any synthesizer type stuff. What is it? What are you playing exactly? I'm just curious. It's so good.
Everything. Okay. Exactly. I play everything except for the beat itself, which coming out of here. See, if I don't do it, it'll just continue doing this.
Right.
But I have an ability to actually direct this, so I can take the chord. You can play pretty much. So you got to go and pick up the style. Let's just say you want like a bossa. Well, this is called something. What's it called? Jazzy funk.
Right.
But you pick up the, I don't know, bossa nova or something.
It's a rhythm track.
Yeah. So there's something like a quartet, for example. You know? Whatever comes to your mind, you can play. It will just follow you, which is nice.
We're gonna move on. Thank you, Vadim.
Yeah,
that was
on,
beautiful.
Thanks.
Tom, are you ready to give us a story? Tell us a story.
Sure.
Yay!
I've taken so many notes listening to all of this that I can barely find my own notes for the story here, but. I really wish that I had studied music. Anyway, in working in Silicon Valley, I've met a lot of extraordinary people who anywhere else would just be regular people. But when you come to a place where there's no boundaries or no perceived boundaries, it just magnifies both virtues and vices. And I thought I'd tell you about one guy that was a client of mine in the early 80s. He started one of the first personal computing companies, and in 4 years sold the company and cashed out with $12 million. And he was going to invest all that in a new company because the PC business still had a long way to go in the early 80s. So he was going to start another company, and he hired me to be his PR guy. And I said, why are you doing this? You got $12 million in the bank. Why are you risking it? I mean, you could live very comfortably on $12 million for the rest of your life. I mean, you're young, you're 40, you couldn't spend it all. He said, and he looked at me the way Silicon Valley people look at outsiders or newcomers. He said, oh, Tom, you're so innocent. You think $12 million is rich? And I said, yeah, I do. He said, no. Rich starts at $150 million. And I didn't know that. I'd never even conceived that there was such a thing as $150 million. Of course, today Bezos has a net worth of $2 billion. So that's how naive we all were back then. And I said, well, where do you get that figure, $150 million? Well, it turns out that somebody had started a semiconductor company and sold it after 10 years or whatever. And he cashed out with $150 million. So that was the new gold standard. If you fell short of $150 million, you weren't trying. So he was going to parlay that $12 million into his next big move, which would get him $150. And he hired me to help make it happen. Me, who thought that if I had $12 million, I'd retire to Tahiti. So with all that money at his disposal, he just went wild. But whenever we fly someplace and have to stop at a big city, his wife would come along and she would call the nearest megastore, not Macy's or Nordstrom, but like Saks or whatever, to come out and bring a load of shoes for her to try on at the airport. Because the time between flights wasn't enough to go into Los Angeles or New York, but they would bring the shoes to her. And he put together an office with the biggest goddamn desk I ever saw. It was a command module that with your arms outstretched, you couldn't reach the side of it. And it wasn't flat, it was curved, like I guess the command module on a starship. And let's see what else he did. We went to Paris once and he took us to a very, very fine hotel where they have this procedure I'd never seen it before. Maybe some of you have, where they give a menu to everybody, but only the host sees the price tags, the prices of the meals. So you're invited to just order whatever you want. And when the chef when the waiter explained that to him and he looked at the prices, he kind of stumbled like, oh my God, what have I gotten myself into? But you know, we were there and he wasn't going to back out. Have no idea what our meal cost, but he knew even before we made our first order. He made most of his career selling computers in Europe. So he knew the European custom of whatever's going on at 4 o'clock, you retire to the best hotel in town and have tea and do business in the tea room of the best hotel in London or wherever. His favorite was the Savoy in London. And so he was living the good life, you know, and he was going to base it all on, he was going to throw it all on the next shot. So for instance, at that dinner in Paris, yeah, I was a little shocked for him to see what he was going to pay, but it's okay. He was willing to plow that 12 million to make his 150. And so he hired the Orient Express and he filled it with editors from European trade magazines, from all the business publications, the US representatives of US publications, trade publications. And we had the Orient Express to ourselves between Paris and London. And I guess now it probably goes through the tunnel, but back then you had to get off and get on a boat to cross the channel. Being on the Orient Express is like you've left planet Earth. The luxury is beyond sumptuous. And I've always seen my role model in life as Columbo. So I took my raincoat off, I rolled it up, and I was about to toss it in the upstairs rack. And a French valet came and took it from me and said, I said, that's okay, I'm just gonna throw it up here. He said, sir, we do not throw anything on the Orient Express. And he set it out for dry cleaning while we were on the train. And things like that happened. It was just the silver, the tea was served in a silver tea service that was so hot, the water stayed almost at the boiling point for 4 hours. That's a lot of silver that takes to do that. When we got back to the States, he was feeling so flushed that he bought a new Rolls Royce. And then things started to go down. It turns out that somebody decided to sue him over copyright for his name, the name of the company he had picked, and spent tens of thousands of dollars on marketing material for a company name that somebody already had. And the next thing that happened was he took his Rolls Royce and his wife to an event in San Francisco. And while it was in a parking lot, somebody keyed it the first month he had it. And it turns out there's only one firm in all of California that does body work on Rolls Royces. And it's in a small town in the Central Valley. So he had to send his brand new Rolls Royce away for a month in the hospital. Unfortunately, he lost the whole pot. And it makes a good story, I think, but he was kind of typical of the Valley mentality, which is you got a nice steak, put it down for the next shot. For me, I guess as a Midwesterner, I would have thought, I'll retire comfortably and just build a shack on Lake Mosquito out there, Lake Wobegon, and be happy for the rest of my life. Anyway, that's my story about an entrepreneur in Silicon Valley back circa 1982.
Wow. Great story. Thank you, Tom. Your role as an advisor to him was over what were you, what was your consulting or advising role for him again? What were you doing for him?
Well, I'd never had a client that had a budget like that. The only people who had really mastered that kind of product rollout was Jobs. I was at the first conference that they had in 1980. It was a trade show. Apple bought Disneyland for the night and gave out tickets to everybody at Disneyland or everybody at the trade show for them and their families to be their guest free at Disneyland. And I remember it because it's the only time I ever got to do Space Mountain four times in one evening, because 20,000 people at Disneyland is nothing. And that staked Apple out and they never looked back.
Was this rich guy, what was your role for the rich guy? PR or?
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
He was a visionary. He would say, we're going to rent the Orient Express, make it happen.
Jesus.
So I made it happen. And he got great press.
Obviously. Wow.
Thanks, Tom. Great story.
Thanks.
Okay, Dave Sherman.
Well, all right. I don't know if I can top that story, but I can play some blues for you. Because it's what I do.
Yay.
I wish I could play blues.
Well,
I don't have 10,000 hours left.
yeah, I'm gonna do a little Jimmy Reed tune. I'm a real good lover, a natural born lover. But I said, tell me, baby, is it wealth or love? Would you rather? Don't need no mansion or a diamond ring, fancy furs or anything, 'cause I'm a real good lover, natural born lover. But I said, tell me, baby, is it wealth or love? Would you rather? So tell me, baby, is it wealth or love? Would you rather?
All right.
Thank you. Thank you.
Nice job, Dave.
Thank you. Thank you.
Great work.
You know, last week I did. I did a Muddy Waters tune, I'm Ready. And I did it kind of like the original might have been done. And then last Thursday, Gant did it, and he did it more like a shuffle. And now I'm gonna do it like a boogaloo. And it's kind of a lesson of what the blues is really all about. It's really all blues is poetry, and you can kind of set it to any kind of groove that you want to set it to. Anyway. Can be. I'm ready. I'm ready as anybody can be.
I'm ready for you. I'm hoping you're ready for me. I got an accidental pistol on a graveyard frame. I'm shooting tombstone bullets. I'm dragging balls and chain. I'm drinking TNT. I'm smoking dynamite. And I hope some screwball wanna fight. Cause I'm red. Red as anybody can be. I'm ready for you. I hope you ready for me. Been drinking gin like never before. I feel so good that I want you to know. One more drink and I wish you would. It'd take a whole lot of your loving just to make me feel good. Cause I'm ready, ready as anybody can be. I'm ready for you. Hope you're ready for me. Like I ain't nowhere. Stop what you done, honey. Come over, yeah. And I prove to you, baby, that I ain't no square. Cause I'm ready. Ready as anybody can be. I'm ready for you. I hope you're ready for me. But I'm ready. Red as anybody can be. I'm ready. Red as anybody can be. I'm ready for you, and I hope you're ready for me.
Go, Pops.
Yeah. Get that groove.
Fuck, sorry.
You know what? I like this version the best, to be honest with you. Mm. I love it. That's the best version. That's the just a comment. The other one is, I have a question about the previous song. So you're really good lover, that's it, right? That's all she needs. Is that your opinion or hers? Okay.
It's hers.
There you go. Just checking.
It's hers. That's all she needs.
All right, there we go. I thought I asked because you know my wife has a different opinion, but that's all right.
Well, you got it. You know, it depends on the
on the wife.
On the wife, yeah.
I got you. Yeah.
Thanks, Dave. That was awesome.
Thank you.
Bill Sherman, are you out there somewhere?
Bill? Why in the world would you make me follow my brother? Oh, no. So I was very inspired a couple weeks ago, and I checked in with him. He was okay with it. When Ed did a Smokey Robinson tune. Now I'm caught up in that groove that Dave had. I don't like you, but I love you. It seems that I'm always thinking of you. Whoa, 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 you treat me badly. I love you madly. You really got a hold on me. You really got a hold on me, baby. But I don't want you, but I need you. Don't wanna kiss you, but I need to. Whoa, 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 you treat me wrong now. My love is strong now. You really got a hold on me. You really got a hold on me. 'Cause I love you and all I want you to do is just hold me, hold me, hold me, hold me. Tighter, tighter. I wanna leave you, don't wanna stay here, don't wanna spend another day here. Whoa, 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 our love is strong now, just can't quit now. You really got a hold on me. You really got a hold on me, baby, yeah. 'Cause I love you and all I want you to do is just hold me and please me and squeeze me and hold me. Tighter, tighter, yeah, tighter.
You heard John.
Very
Lennon.
Nice.
You heard John.
I don't think it was as good as what you did 2 weeks ago, Ed. But
oh, come on, that was great.
And then, a Sparks Brothers song, Pine Top Sparks and Milton Sparks, written back in the 30s.
Go.
Every day I've got the blues. Every day. Every day I've got the blues. When you see me, wait, baby. Well, it's you I'd hate to lose. Nobody loves me. Nobody seems to care. Nobody loves me, nobody seems to care. And talking about worried and bad luck, mama, well, you know I've had my share. Every day, every day, every day I've got the blues. Every day, every day, every day, every day, every day I've got the blues. When you see me, would baby, well, it's you I'd hate to lose. My suitcase, I'm gonna move it on down the line. I'm gonna pack up my suitcase, I'm gonna move it on down the line. Where the shore ain't nobody worrying, and the shore ain't nobody crying. 'Cause every day, 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 baby. Every day I've got the blues. when you see me worried, baby, well, it's you I'd hate to lose. When you see me worried, mama, well, it's you I'd hate to lose. When you see me worried, baby, well, it's you I'd hate to lose.
That was very good.
Well done, Bill.
Thank you.
Good job, Bill.
Whatever key that was in worked really well with your voice.
That's pretty much all. That and maybe one other key are the only two keys that do work well with my voice. That was an E. Much of what I do is in.
I'm being a little of an idiot when you said, my brother, this is a joke or real? He is your brother.
Oh, no, he's my brother.
Okay, didn't know. Just asked.
Thanks, Bill. That was awesome.
Thank you.
Oh, okay. Good night. I'm going to head out. Sorry.
Arlene, are you out there?
Good night, Megan. Stay well.
Good night. Oh. Thank you.
Thanks. Bye.
Yes, okay, next Wednesday, job, what's the name of the place you're playing next Wednesday, Megan?
Java Nation.
Java Nation. Okay.
Yeah.
Hi, Megan.
See you.
I didn't see your text.
Wish I could be there.
Okay, Arlene, are you ready to go next?
Yes, I am ready to go next. And I am doing a cappella still because that is my style. And I'm going back to comfort. And I hope that you guys will recognize it. Should I tell you what it is in advance?
Yes, some of us might not know it, so.
All right, well, it is an unfamiliar song to many called Let It Be by the Beatles. Not many people know about that song. That was a joke, but.
Wait. People don't remember that song?
Sorry?
There's a lot of people that don't know that song?
I was being facetious.
She's being facetious.
I'm going to say, you're obviously being facetious here, right? Yeah.
Yeah. So it will be a cappella. And this song means a lot to me. When I had a head injury, it was a life to me to keep myself grounded. Found myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Amidst my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Let it be, let it be. Let it be, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be. Now the broken-hearted people living in the world agree, there will be an answer, let it be. Will they be parted? There is still a chance that they will see. There will be an answer. Let it be. 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 There will be as a wisdom. Let it be. 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 Will be an answer, let it be.
A great song and very nicely done, thank you.
It's a perfect song. Perfect song for Paul McCartney, who was Irish Catholic in Liverpool. It's got Catholic lyrics about Holy Mary, Mother, but a real heavy Anglican beat. Bum, 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 bum. It's a, mm-hmm. Kind of a piece for Liverpool.
Was his mother's actual name?
The Mother Mary isn't
biblical. His mother, Mary. Yeah.
Beautiful, beautiful.
As biblical Mary.
Loved one line, but thank you.
That was great, Arlene.
Thank you.
Yep.
And I am going back to the Beatles for number two. Because
all right.
And this one's a little bit more up. So we'll start this. So hold on a second. Let me do this again. Let's think about this. Okay. Redbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your life. You're only waiting for this moment to be free. Blackbird fly. Blackbird fly. Into the light of the dark black night. Blackbird fly, blackbird fly, into the light of the dark black night.
Beautiful.
Yeah, did you know that McCartney said that they were not a very political band, but he was inspired to write that song by the American Civil Rights Movement?
Yeah.
It's kind of interesting.
You know what? Somebody's going to have to accompany me next time.
I wish that we could.
Yeah,
it's just that the latency on the computer, things would be like
normal.
Yeah.
Thanks, Arlene. That's beautiful. Warren, do you want to go next?
Warren, yeah, I'll go next.
If you need a dummy,
so
to ever, like, test
from
stuff.
I think I'll try to. Play a new song for you that I wrote the other day, but I'm gonna go ahead and play another one first, just so I get something right here, because we'll see. I might fuck up these lyrics entirely on the next song here, but this one's Orange and Blue. This song's about Adderall and about heartbreak. Can you all hear me? Orange
orange and blue. How I wish that were true. When I wake up staring at the ceiling, I start to get the feeling of this world's weight crushing in. Now it's evening, I'm still watching the paint peeling. There's got to be a reason for this twisted shape I'm in. I got to do a little bit better tomorrow. Gotta get my body moving, and my soul will follow orange and blue. Keep me company so I won't think of you. Black coffee, that'll do. Orange and blue. Keep my mind off anything I want to. Orange and blue. How I wish that were true.
A crowd in person too?
I do. I'm recording at my friend Dave's house here tonight, and got neighbors over, and luckily his daughter and friend just showed up. So yeah.
Very cool.
All right, I'll go ahead and try to play this one that I wrote yesterday, and we'll see. I might fuck up the lyrics a lot, but we'll see how it goes. This one's called Too Old to Die Young. Sometimes I get sad when I start to think it. And then thoughts turn bad and I turn to drinking. I don't know what tomorrow will bring. All I know is that this cage bird's gotta sing. Gonna keep raising
cocaine. As long as I'm able, I'm gonna keep on drinking till I'm under the table. Got a bullfight of spirit and a courtier's tongue. Lord knows that I'm too damn old to die young. Too old to die young. Too old to die young. I'll keep on singing till there's no sad song on the song. I'm lying there in the dirt, and I no longer feel hurt. Well, the birds will all sing in harmony, while the trees and the flowers dance. Well, I know I drone on about my depression, but a song's a lot cheaper than a therapy session. Besides, I don't trust all the pills that they give me. I'd rather stick to amphetamines and whiskey. I tried living fast, but I ain't died yet. Sometimes I sure as hell feel like it. Smoked so much weed I have killed my lungs. When I realize that I'm too damn old to die young. Too old to die young. Too old to die young. I'll keep singing till there's no sad song in the sun. I'm lying there in the dirt, and I no longer feel hurt. The birds will sing in harmony while the trees and the flowers dance.
Great title, definitely. I can identify.
Great song, Warren. I love it. I want to hear it again next time. That was awesome. Great lyrics.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Okay, so it's time for our closer, Mr. Gant Kushner.
A closer.
No pressure.
Enter Sandman.
No Metallica. Okay. Well, can you hear me?
Very well.
I think I've done this before, I think, but I don't think I did it very well. I probably won't do it very well this time either, but we'll see what happens. I want you in my arms when I want you, and all your charms whenever I want you. All I have to do is dream when I feel blue in the night. I need you to hold me tight whenever I want you. All I have to do is dream. I can make you mine, taste your lips of wine anytime, night.
day. Only trouble is, gee whiz, I'm dreaming my life away. I love you so, and that is why I need you so, and I could die. Dream, 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 I can make you mine. Taste your lips of wine, anytime, night or day. Only trouble is, gee whiz, I'm dreaming my life away. Love you so.
That's a great tune. Doing that, Cam.
That was great.
Full 60s.
Boo-boo Bryant.
Gee whiz.
Gee whiz.
50s, really.
I don't
okay.
Maybe I'll do this one.
Well, you know, I wish we could have done that. I was singing harmony to you, so. Yeah, just like the Everly Brothers.
One of these days.
But we'll never know, will we?
All right, this is one of my all-time favorite songs written by Kris Kristofferson. See him wasted on the sidewalk, in his jacket and his jeans, where yesterday's misfortunes like a smile. Once he had a future full of money, hope, and dreams, which he spent like they were going out of style. And it keeps right on changing, for the better or the worse, searching for some shrine he's never found, never knowing if believing is a blessing or a curse, or if the going up is worth the coming down. Because he's a poet, he's a picker, he's a prophet, he's a pusher, he's a pilgrim and a preacher, and a problem with a stone. He's a walking contradiction, partly truth, partly fiction, taking every wrong direction on his only way back home. He has tasted good and evil, your bedrooms and your bars, traded in tomorrow for today, chasing down his demons, Lord, and reaching for the stars, using all he had along the way. His world, it keeps on changing, for the better or the worse, all he ever gets is older and around. From the rocking of the cradle to the rolling of the hearse, going up is worth the coming down. Because he's a poet, he's a picker, he's a prophet, he's a pusher, he's a pilgrim and a preacher, and a problem with a stone. He's a walking contradiction, part of the truth, part of the fiction, taking every wrong direction on his lonely way back home. Taking every wrong direction on his lonely way back home.
Yeah.
good stuff.
Good stuff.
Maybe best for last.
Always.
Nope. Yay, Kat.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, that's our show, everybody. Woo-hoo! Thanks, Kat.
So
Thanks,
Dave.
Thank you. Louise.
Thanks, Bill. Thanks
for running it.
There, Louise.
Thanks a lot, Marie-Louise.
Please share when you can when you're performing live. That would be great. Love to see you.
Thanks, Warren.
Thanks so much.
Good night, all.
Love you all.
Thanks, everybody. Have a good night.
See you next time.
Thanks, Vadim.
Bye.
Well, I'll keep it on until she closes out. Okay.
Lee?